So, when you are given this problem and you need to judge, has have first guess, يعني عايز تشوف how long it will take. How long this problem will take? It will take the time needed to solve two equations. Why two equations? Because we have two mesh. So you are given the problem. Look how many mesh we have? N mesh. So we need N equation. In the node, we need number of position nodes minus one, as Hussam said. So you will have first guess. Again, this is a rough estimation. That تقريبي. It might be this, we might have this, and you have only one equation. You know when? When can we have one equation? If we have, يعني, I will give two bonus if you answer this. And here we need two equations. When can we play with the circuit to have only one equation? What you can do here to have one equation only?
Solar mesh?
How? يعني it's in the circuit. What we change to solve only one equation? Muhammad.
We
don't have the seal. Hussein.
Maybe if there isn't a 6-ohm resistor.
If
there wasn't a 6-ohm resistor.
And if there's no resistor, it will be one equation. But I need to have something here. I make it easy for you. I need to have something here to make this one equation.
Maybe R equivalent?
No.
Yeah, I would say.
No.
Invert to current source.
Invert what?
The voltage sources.
This invert to current source?
Yeah.
This also can be done. Yeah. If this or this is a current source, so one current is known. Are you getting this?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. If this a current source, whatever current source here. This is good. What's the name? Avilea. Yeah. So if you have a current source here. What does this mean? 5 ampere. What does this mean?
I2
is 5 ampere.
Yeah.
Done. So we need only one machine. Okay? If this replaced by a current source, another current source, how many equations need to solve?
Zero.
I1 now is this current source. So I1 and I2 are known. Done? So the current each branch is known. So more current source in this circuit, less equation. Most likely less equation. More current source in the branches, less number of equation. This is not the answer I need to have. يعني, what else we can do? يعني, we said we can replace this guy or this guy by current. What else? You said something.
Okay.
You said something. Who didn't say?
Hussein. What's a voltage source?
No, this will make things complicated actually. Naif.
Maybe if we know the shunt and the 6 ohm.
If we replace 6 ohm with any current source, we have only one equation to solve. Are you getting this? If this guy is a current source now, how many equations need to solve? What's the meaning of a current source here?
So,
huh? Again, this is a current source, something like this. Amen? Equal to whatever, 1 ampere. What does this mean, current source down? It means I1 minus I2 equal to
1
ampere. So we have one free equation. Look at the current I1, got down, and I2 up. So this current is I1 minus I2, 1 ampere. So you have one free equation, no time, you write this. Huh?
Yes.
What we call this scenario? Super mesh. This is SA, this is super mesh. You remember the super node? When you have a voltage source between two essential nodes, we can easily find the voltage on the sides of the voltage. So here, if you have a current source, between two mesh, this is a super mesh. Tamam? Again, you have three equation. One free equation, I1 minus I2 is 1 ampere. Tamam? You don't need to take KVL here. You don't need this two equation now. Tamam? Wait. I still need one more equation. From where I can get the other equation? Raise your hand if you. Raise your hand. What is the bonus? So I have current source in the middle, and I have found that this current source will give you I1 minus I2. I need one more equation. From where I can get the other equation? Any idea, Muhammad?
We take the full load.
Can we take machine?
Yes.
Yes.
Hey. If you take ratio unit as a whole, minus 10 plus 2, I 1 plus 1.
1.
Huh? 1 is the current. We need to add voltage. It's KVL. In mesh, we are using KVL. Can we take KVL here?
No.
Huh? You have a current source.
Plus I
1 minus. I jumped a little bit, but it's nice. Yani. I think you know what we are seeing here. Look here at this circuit. How many mesh we have?
Three
mesh. 1, 2, 3. So I1, I2, I3. I1 is clockwise, I2 clockwise, I3 clockwise. How many equations need to solve?
Three
equations. It's the first guess. As I said, first guess. It might be less. So I have three mesh. I need three equations. Right? Is this right? Is this accurate? Do we need three? Three equations means three KVL. Take KVL three times. Do we need this?
No.
Let's see. As we have done, take KVL here. Take KVL here. It will be I1 R1, right? Plus I1 minus I3. The current, what is the current here?
R2.
I1, the current here, actually. Mm-hmm. I1 minus I3 times R2. What's the voltage here? You need to ask the voltage here. Don't throw. You can't use KVL here in this mesh. You can't use KVL here. Reject it. You can't do this. It will not work. Similar. And we cannot use a KVL here or here. We can use KVL here. KVL can be done. So what should we do?
Combine.
I can take one equation only from here. Then I take super mesh, which is a gray area. Gray area can be used as a this is a shabab called super mesh. Super mesh, which is this mesh. Very easy. One big mesh, super mesh, KVL in this loop, and KVL in this loop. How many equations we have?
Two.
Two equations. I still need one more equation. Right? I have three unknowns, I1, I2, I3. I have three unknowns in shabab. I1, I2, I3. So I need like three equations. Super mesh will give you one equation. Super mesh will give you the gray loop. Another loop up there, the top mesh will give you another equation. Top mesh. The top guard here. Another mesh. I need one more equation. I have 1, 2, 3. Yes.
The big loop.
This is difficult. To take the big loop is difficult. And it might produce a dependent equation. And if you take the big loop, it might not be useful. It will be like adding these two equations together. Yes.
The IS2.
IS2 is?
The difference between...
Look at IS2. Look at this current source. What's IS2?
Yeah.
I2 minus
I1. It's the third equation. The super mesh equation. Third equation is that IS2 is...
I2
minus I1. This is a free equation. It's a free equation. No KVL. Just you look here at IS up. Go with I2 up and I1 down. So this free equation. It takes less than 1 second to write the equation. And another two KVL. You have three equations. So this is not really three equations. We need only two equations. We need to write two equations. Because we have current source which will save you another equation. So using the mesh, we need to solve two equations because we have super mesh. You will have three equations, so we need to write KVL twice. Let's write the foot. Yes, yes,
can you say again why we can't take KVL?
Okay, let's take KVL here in this loop. This is a mesh, right? Tell me, what's KVL? KVL in this loop, yes. Start from anything, from any element. R1 times I1. We said we'll go with the positive side. I1 times R1. Then?
R2.
R2 times?
R1 minus R3.
Yes. Look at I2. R2, I will take the current here, which is what? I1 minus I3. Look at even the value rotate. So plus I1 minus I3 times R2. Then, what's next? You need to take the voltage here, which is what? We don't know. You will know later when you solve the whole circuit, you can find the voltage here by KVL or whatever. But now we don't know the voltage. You cannot continue with this KVL. Okay, when you have current source anywhere, you cannot direct KVL. Is this clear, Hassan?
Yes.
Take KVL here, Hassan. If you take KVL here, you will be stuck here. So this is rejected, as I said. Again, Yashabab, when you have a current source, no KVL, forget it. Forget KVL here, forget KVL here. But you can take KVL here. Super mesh. Tamam? So this is one equation. KVL here, you can take KVL. What's the other equation? From the mesh here. So let's write KVL in the top equation, in the top mesh. Write KVL in the top mesh. Do we need to write KVL in the top mesh? What's your name?
Fahd.
Can we take KVL here, Fahd?
Yes.
Okay, tell me what's KVL.
It will be R2.
Okay, R2.
Times R1 minus R3.
Okay.
Plus I2 minus I3 times R3.
Okay, plus what's the voltage? We don't know the voltage. You cannot do it. You don't need to do it.
Yes.
This current source here, IS1 equal to 1. What's IS1 here? In terms of the mesh current.
Minus
I3. So it's another free equation. So not super mesh, but you have a current source in the mesh. The current source in this mesh gives you the current for free. So actually we have two free equations. We have one. What is the other free equation, Fahd?
IS2
equal to?
I2 minus I1.
So we have one, two free equations. One second, exactly, to write these two equations. It is new for you, but when you, next time you will take 1 second to write. So how many equations we need to, how many KVL we need to take? One KVL, which is the super mesh KVL here. That's it. So two free equation and one KVL equation. Okay, Shabbat? So the problem is very easy. This problem is very easy. Why? What makes this problem easy? We have two current sources. How many current sources we have?
Two.
This gives you two free equations. Each equation takes 1 second. 2 seconds. Tamam? So what is left? I have three unknowns. I want 2, 3. I have one more equation. From where do we get the other equation? So can you tell me KVL in the only KVL we need to write? Can you tell me KVL, Shabbat? KVL. Where KVL to be taken? In the gray mesh, the gray loop or super mesh. Okay? Start from any element. Yeah, who can help me? What's your name?
Abdulatif.
Okay, Abdulatif. Tell me.
R1 multiply
R1. I1 R1? Exactly. I1 R1?
Plus R2 multiply I1 minus I3.
Okay.
Plus R3 multiply I2 minus I3.
It's your lady. But do you know why I2 minus I3 here?
Yes, I2.
Abdulatif, sir?
Yes.
You know why I2 minus I3 here? Why here? Look at me. The guy wrote it, but in the exam will not write it to you. Because I2 is moving this way.
Yes.
And I see the opposite, so I2 minus I3. Okay, plus R3, I2 minus I3. Plus?
Plus R4 multiply I2.
I2 only, or you should have I1 here or I3?
No.
I2. No. So, as you can see, this two free equation, one super mesh equation, which is this equation. So we have 1, 2, 3 equation and 3 unknowns, which will take another minute, 1 minute more to solve. The whole problem will take maximum 5 minutes for the average student. Assuming you have done good practice at home, assuming you have spent day and night working on homework, okay? Tal, this problem using mesh, it will take 5 minutes, 5 to 7 minutes. If we need to use node analysis, how long it will take? How many equations we need to solve?
Three.
How many station nodes we have?
Four.
We have 1, 2, 3, and this can be graphed. So you need to write 3 equations. 3 full equations and solve them. Okay, 3 equations, 3 unknowns. Use calculator, you might get something wrong. It will take how long? At least 10 minutes, if you are young, if you are good. So again, you have to be wise. From where we get the wisdom?
Mm-hmm.
ومن يؤت الحكمة فيرميبرز إيه ومن يؤت الحكمة فقد أوتيه خيرا كثيرا فيرميبر ويليام. So I hope يعني will Allah grant you this wisdom. We need to find the voltage V, anything. We need to find the voltage V, or the current here, or the current here, or the current. We need to find any يعني voltage. How can we find this voltage? Again, choose node or mesh.
Mesh.
Do you have more voltage source or more current source?
Current.
More current source make your mind go toward the mesh. Okay. More voltage source. Think about node. Yeah, think about node, yeah, more voltage source, node might be easier, okay? More current source, mesh looks easier, yes?
Because also we have three equations, two, three equations.
How many mesh we have?
Three
mesh. The first guess is we need three equations. I want two, three.
No.
Do we really need three? The first guess, تخمين الأول. Do we really need three equations?
No.
So how many equations, how many actually give in or need to run?
Two.
One given, because we have two current sources, so two current are unknown, or two equations are free, because right we have two current sources, two equations are free. What are the free equations? Can you tell anyone tell me? Yeah, the free equations. So this current equal to assume I1, I2, I3. Come on. We have I1, I2, I3. Let's start. What is I1, Muhammad?
One.
I1 is one. First free equation. The other guy will give me another free, which is what? Yeah, what's free?
Anas.
Anas. What is the other equation, Anas?
I2.
I2?
Equal to.
I2 equal to 2. I2?
Minus
equal to 2. Is this correct?
No.
Minus.
Huh?
No. Minus
I2. Look at this current source. I2. What current here is? What current is moving here? What mesh current? What current? I2 minus I3. We have I3 here. So I2, okay, Anas?
Okay.
We have I2 minus I3 equal to another free equation. Two free equations, two set. I3 equal to, sorry, I1. The only current here is I1. No I2, no I3. The current here is I2 minus I3, which is 2. Two free equations. We still need one more equation, which apparently will come from KVL using certain loop. Which loop should be? Please run the film. We need one more equation. We have I1, 2, 3. I have two equations. I need one more equation. From where we get the other equation, we need to take KVL around some closed loop. Which loop, which line we should follow? This is the question, Hassan?
Yes.
Please run the film. Trying to find someone who did this week. Okay. What's your name?
Muhammad.
Muhammad. Where is that? تعال هنا محمد صار. تعال صار هنا مش مش. قلت لي محمد. تعال هنا.
هذه.
محمد wants to take this loop. Okay. Tell me what's key.
نبدأ بس ال ما في هنا أساس.
You can't take it. You don't want the voltage. Can't be done. Mm-hmm. شكرا يا محمد.
The bigger one.
Is this one, right?
Yeah.
Again, what is the voltage? When you pass by this, what's the voltage? You don't know. Okay. Any current source you will pass by, can't be done. يعني you can't take KVL and pass by a current source. You don't know the voltage. It will not work. Okay, you have to find a loop without current source, which is, I guess, one single loop can be taken.
Yeah.
One single loop, which is what, ya Muhammad? Come here, ya Muhammad. You hold the teacher's. Does this make sense, Yashabat?
Yes.
Yes. This is there another loop, Steve? Is there another loop? Yes. Can we take another loop? This is one solution. What solution? You didn't get it from here, Muhammad? Did you watch it in the,
no.
From your mind? So this is good solution. This is the third equation, actually. Now we have three equations, three unknowns. It can be done. Is there another loop? Do we take it? Yes.
Can we take super mesh?
This is the super mesh action.
I mean the two below.
This is the super mesh. There's no other super mesh.
There's no other
loop. Can we? Can we take another loop? Can we take another closed line and find QVA? Think of it.
Maybe the
opposite.
نبدأ من هنا.
Again, you will be stuck with this. You can't bypass by current source. What I'm saying, you cannot have current source on your way. It will not work. We have to skip this. We have to find a loop without a current source. Shukran. Okay. Again, Muhammad, the guy who solved it. Is there another loop, Muhammad, can be taken? This is the only loop can be. There's no other option. Tamam? This is the only. This is a super mesh action. This is called. Super mesh. Okay, شباب. This is a super mesh. No other solution. Absolutely no other solution. So you have two free equation from the two current source as I explained, and this gray. So this is super mesh. تمام؟ I'm sure you can take super mesh. Last equation you can write it. Right, شباب. طيب, this is the mesh analysis. I didn't cover all the problems because we have some more problems, but I covered the basic ideas. I covered what you need to know. The remaining part is easy. Let's take another thing. Okay, so we are done with the super mesh. Let's take another concept. Is the super mesh clear, شباب? Enjoy it.
What section is this?
Section 2.5. We have just finished 2.5. Now we start section 2.6. And the measure is covering up to the section 2.6. Section 2.6 is somehow big, a little bit big. Okay? So we cover it today and Wednesday, inshallah. Okay, Shabbat. Today, inshallah, we start a new section. It's called the Thevenin and the Norton equivalent circuit. A guy called Thevenin, another guy called Norton. These two guys have invented some technique to make solution easy. Yeah, this is a new method to do the same stuff, to analyze the circuit, to solve the circuits. In addition to how many methods we have taken? KVL, KCL. These are the father and the mother. Then they have kids. What are the kids? Voltage divider, current divider, node, mesh. Any other thing we have taken? Now we
converting source and
series barrier combination squeezing the circuit. Yeah, we have taken several methods to make the solution easy. Today we take a new technique called the Thevenin and Norton equivalent circuit. Okay. In this, under this, we have special concept is called source transformation. Source transformation. What's the meaning of source transformation? What do you have here? You have a voltage source with series resistor. Tamam? What else do we have here between A and B? We have the rest of the circuit. We could have something like this here. Any circuit is connected here. Some circuit is connected here. Tamam? But I'm assuming that I don't see it. Any circuit can be connected here. I focus on this grid, which is a voltage source with current source. Is there a way to remove the voltage source and replace it with a current source? So what we are doing here, we need to transform a voltage to current source or current to voltage source. Why I'm doing this? It will make solution easier in some situation. In some situation, it will make solution very easy. When we transform a voltage to current or current to voltage type, I have here VS. Series with RS. I need to replace this with another thing, which is current and parallel same resistor. Look, RS is the same RS here. If you have 1 ohm, you bring 1 ohm here. And the current source, what direction? Should be moving from positive side. Look at the positive side. The new current source must be from negative to positive. Now I need to assume that this guy is the same as this guy. This guy is the same as this guy. What does it mean? This guy is the same as this guy. And what I'm doing here, shabab, equivalent circuit. Equivalent, so this must be equivalent to this. In what sense? What makes Muhammad same as Ahmed? If the relation between V and I, look V and I here, I'm trying to explain to you. V and I must be the same relation. Okay? Because this source is delivering V and I, and this source is delivering V and I. So if we have the equation relating V and I from here, must be the same equation. What makes the relation is the same? What makes this V and I relation, same V and I relation here? If I S equal to V S over R S. I S is V S over R S. This will make the two guys is the same exactly. Same means they will deliver the same relation to V and R. Tamam? Are you getting this? So what we are doing here, we need to replace a voltage by current source. The new current source must be equal to V S over R S. Why?
When you take the voltage,
because this will force this relation to be the same. If this relation is the same, V and I, so the two guys are the same. So from where we get this equation? Yeah, from where we get this over RS? Just take KVL here, find V and I, take KCL here, find V and I. From the two equations, you can see easily that IS must be VS over RS. Are you getting this?
Yes.
By the way, some people explain this by saying, when you see this guy, remove it and put this guy. The new guy is VS over RS, that's it. Okay? You will do this in the exam, you will take grades. But I need you to understand why you are doing this. From where we got the equation that IS must be VS over RS from this. If you take KVL here, take KVL here, what's V? IRS plus VS. Everyone agree on this?
Yes.
Now, go to the other guy, take KCL here. Look at KCL, what's KCL here? I equal to the current here. What is the current here? V over RS minus IS. This equation from here and this equation from here. Tamam? Now, find multiply RS here. This equation will be RS, VI minus RS. Look at this equation. Now, look at this equation and this equation. What makes them the same? What makes this equation same as this equation? Look carefully. What makes this same as this? If V is equal to I S R S. That's it. Now you understand what we are doing. Now you understand what we are doing. I really like to go deep to make you understand. Yeah, not just the right equation so far. Okay, shabab? So, short, long story short, what we are doing here is, if you are, these two guys will be the same, Jack will be same as Thompson if V is equal to ISRS. If I give you this circuit, remember this is a part of a big circuit. in usually or normally, you will have another stuff here. You will have many stuff here. But we don't care about it. Forget about it. I focus on this part. So I will remove this and put current and voltage source. Can anyone tell me what is the new voltage and current source? So I will replace this. Okay. I will replace this guy by a current source. What direction should be the current source? Up or down?
Down.
From negative to positive. Must be down. If you reverse this, you reverse this. What is the current?
Half.
3 over 6. What's the current resistor? 6, that's it. So you can go from Dammam to Riyadh or the other way around. Up, down, down, up. Why is this? Why we need this? Why we need to do this? I think you know this before from physics?
No.
Okay. Actually, this solution will make things very easy. Time. If I have 8 ampere barium stone, I need to replace this current by voltage source. What's the new voltage source?
16.
Oh.
8 times 2. 16. Yeah. What's the polarity? Is it like this or opposite?
Opposite.
Opposite. So it will be like this, 16. And the guy comes here. 2 ohm comes here. Remember, the 2 ohms, guy is the same as this. This guy is the same as this. Easy? Yes.
Here, we reverse the polarity on the left one, the bottom. We reverse as well in the resistance, so the resistance current go up.
No, the resistance is the same. same resistance comes here. What do you mean
reverse resistance? In A, yeah. Ah. Is the resistance, is the current going up in the resistance?
The current could be up or down. Could be up 1 ampere, down 1 ampere. The current is based on your definition. What is the current here? Could be up or down. 1 ampere minus 1 ampere. Yeah, the current here is the same, still the same. Here or here, the current here must be the same. Okay, Shira? I give you this circuit. I need to find I and Ix. What is I and Ix? This I and this Ix. Tamam? It can be solved using root mesh. Both of them can work. But this equation involved solving independent equation. I need to write some equation and solve them. Tamam, Shabab? Apart from this, maybe you don't use this. What else you can use? We can use source transformation. We have two sources. Which one to transform?
Right
or left? It's based on what left. You want. What do we want here? I and Ix, right? So if you need to find I, it's wise to transform this guy. Because if you change this guy, you still have the same I here. If you replace this, you will have the same I here. So replacing this will make I easy to find. But I still find, I need to find Ix as well. If you replace this, Ix will disappear. If I replace this, Ix disappear. So if I need to find Ix, what should I do? Reverse this guy to current source. So either we will work in this problem, transforming this or this is the same, same difficulty. Another problem, it will be much wiser to choose one of them. One of them will work, the other guy will not work. Okay? What I'm saying here, which one to transform? Either of them will work. Because transforming this will give you I. Transforming this will give you Ix. So which one will choose the shape? Let's transform this guy, the 5 ampere. I will transform this. So the 5 ampere will be here. 5 times 3 is 15, right? And the 3 ohm comes here. This guy, I have replaced this by this. Agree? Polarity is good? This polarity is correct or wrong?
Yes,
correct. The current R, where is this current R? Where is it here? Still here. No change. The current Ix. Where is Ix here?
It
doesn't exist. Ix here is not this Ix. This is no Ix here. To find Ix, you have to go back here. Is this clear? So I have made the transformation. Now, what's next? Find R. How can we find R? Give L here. Very easy. Take L here. Find R. Just give L. I is this source minus this source over 2 plus 3. Look at I moving from 15. So 15 minus 10 over this guy. So I is 1 ampere. The current here, Shabab, is 1 ampere. What does this mean? Current here is 1 ampere. Now, I need to find Ix. Where's Ix? From here or from here? No Ix here. No Ix here. This is not Ix. This is a mistake some of you will do. We'll assume Ix is here. This is no Ix. Ix is the current here. So this is 5, and this is 1. What is this?
4.
That's it. How long does this will take to do transformation and to go back? Two minutes. It should take from you 2 minutes in the exam. Usually we will give you 3-4 minutes to solve this, okay? But with practice, it should take 2 minutes, 3 minutes with this average. Yes.
How do you choose the polarity?
I choose the polarity, look at the current here, current going up, right? Yes. I choose this such that the current is from negative to positive.
Wow. Against the convention?
Against the convention, yes. Because this will make, if you go back to the first slide, when we talk about source transformation, this will make the two steps equivalent. When the current is moving from negative to positive side. This will make the two guys the same. So thank you, Shabab. You can stop the video, Muhammad.